And to get started, if I put the transducer down, the first thing I want to do is put the patient information in. Can you show me how to do that?
Certainly, we have a patient data entry key here. You'll notice here that we have all of the information that we would want. And you just use your trackball, place a number, and then you can tab over.
Okay.
And then put the last name. In this case, we'll put like 28 weeks.
Okay.
All right. We also have all the other identification you would want, referring physician, anything you would want here. For today's purpose, we'll just put in the due date under the additional tab. And it would be...
I see that we can do different. If we were just doing a GYN, we could pick that one. Okay.
Absolutely. And based upon what type of exam we told we were going to do, in this case OB, then it automatically should have brought that up.
Okay.
And then the due date here.
Here we go. Do you know your due date?
September 26th.
Okay. Okay, and then that generates how many weeks she should be today, and then we just hit OK?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Okay. Okay, great.
Now we also have to, of course, choose the appropriate transducer. In this case, we're using a C5-2, which is a good abdominal transducer. We also have the V6-2, which would be for 3D, and then we would choose the appropriate preset based upon what we're doing, of course, today in OB. And those are the controls you have here. So now we have our basic 2D image. Mm-hmm. And what you want to do to optimize the image, or let's go over the control panel just a little bit. Your trackball is your basic, where most of your controls are going to be changed or values changed or that sort of thing, your calculations. So it's right here in front of you with your left hand. You can adjust all that. This system, your mode keys are grouped together here. So you have your color pariangio, your directional CPA, M mode, your pulsed wave, and your color right here for you.
Mm-hmm.
These are where you would do your measurements, turn on your calculations, do any kind of annotations, body markers. All of this is grouped here on this side for you.
More labeling and measuring.
Okay. Right. Absolutely.
Okay.
So your depth is here where you'd want to change your depth to. Okay. You want to optimize your depth. You don't want to have the baby in the very top part. You want to be able to have the appropriate depth position.
So if I toggle down, I'll go deeper into the body, and if I toggle up, I'll get more shallow.
More superficial,
okay.
Yes. And then your focus is, the ideal focal point will be right at the area of interest or just below.
Okay. And I have that indicator here.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Can I change the number of focal zones, or do I just have one?
Yes, you can. That when we're in 2D, this will be our 2D controls here.
Okay.
So the theory behind this is the top row are on, off, or changing, like in this case, left, right, harmonics on, off. And to answer your question, the focal zone number is here. So that would be a number where you would turn.
So this 6 indicates correlates with this 6 here, and as I turn, I'm going to increase.
Yes.
Number. Okay. And then to move my focal zones, I use this lever.
Yes.
And then to bring it back to one focal zone, I'll do here.
Mm-hmm.
And then the idea behind focal zones, the more focal zones I have, the better resolution, however, a slower time.
Theoretically, yes, but if you were doing small parts or that sort of thing, that's where you'll see the real difference in the focal zone placement. In OB, not really so much.
Right. We want to keep a fast frame rate, so we really usually should use a one.
Yes.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Great. Okay, so that's our focal zones and our depth.
Mm-hmm.
And for dual screen, that's here?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I pick that. And how do I toggle between?
You would go either, you could press this or you could go either side. This indicator here tells you which one is your active mode. And then you have a red indicator here that tells you which one is your active screen.
Okay. Okay, excellent. And then to get out of that, do I 2D?
Yes. Uh-huh.
Okay. 2D. Okay, so let's talk about these for the user that may not be familiar with what does 2D mean, M mode, what does that mean? Should we show those here? So to use color, and how would I adjust the size and scale of this color box?
To adjust the size, your controls are going to be here. Once again, we talked about your trackball function.
Okay.
This is box position, And then you could just press either one of those select keys to the side of that, and it'll change to highlight the box.
Okay.
So whatever mode you're in, that's what your trackball will allow you to adjust.
Okay, so I can toggle back and forth. I can move my box when I'm in box position.
Correct.
I hit the select key, and then I can adjust the box large or small.
Correct. Uh-huh.
Okay. And let's say I think this color is too sensitive or not sensitive enough, and I want to change my...
Two ways. You can change your PRF directly by your scale.
Okay.
But we also have a quick key that will help you with your flow optimization that will change your scale, your baseline, some other factors that just by once again turning this number 5 button would allow you to change your flow state. Lower flow state, for instance, if you were looking for renal kidney flow or that sort of thing. Higher flow state would be like maybe the fetal heart, something with a faster flow state.
Excellent.
You still have control of those controls, but this is like a macro key to be able to help you with
that.
That's
nice. Very nice. Okay. Color power angio. Do you want to explain that?
Color power angio is looking at, instead of the velocity or the blood flow, it's looking at the amplitude. So the advantage of that is that it's less angle dependent.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're trying to find a piece of cord or something and it's not a good angle looking at it, this will help you to evaluate that.
Okay.
Now, we've also added with that a way of doing a directional portion of that, where here you can see we're just a solid color,
mm-hmm.
but the newer systems you can actually turn on where you can see utilizing the amplitude part of the signal, but you're able to see the direction as well.
Wow,
and I find this
impressive.
Very helpful in the fetal heart to know exactly.
Yeah, the direction, that's nice.
Yes. So that was on the second page.
Okay.
And you can turn that on and turn that off.
Great. And we would change our PRF in the same manner.
Yes.
With our macro key that we have.
You could do it that way or with your scale.
You can do
absolutely.
Your scale right there. Mm-hmm. And as I bring the scale down, it lowers my PRF, which makes it more sensitive.
Yes.
And bringing it up will make it less sensitive. Excellent. Okay. So to get out of any of these, I just press the 2D?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Let's talk about overall gain in TGC for the user. Let's say I walk up to the machine and someone had used it before and it looks like this.
Right.
That happens.
It does. It absolutely does. And gain is important, being able to see the information that you need, of course. And there's a fun, you know, there's, and a lot of it's personal preference. Some people like to scan brighter than others. This is a little too bright,
mm-hmm.
because you're going to add artifact there. And this is too dim, as you saw.
Mm-hmm.
But most systems now have an automatic button to be able to optimize that for you. And in this case, it's called iScan. On the Philips system, it's called iScan.
Oh,
and you
nice.
Still have the adjustment of being able to do if you like. And then the TGC is time gain compensation, where, Julie, if you want to show what, when you move each one of them individually, where you can boost near field, far field, or in between,
mm-hmm.
in a specific part of that.
Okay. And then if I had this all whacked out, you could just hit the eye scan and it corrects it for you?
You could, yes.
Very nice. Let's talk about zoom.
All right.
If we were going to go to the heart, or if I wanted to see an area in more detail.
There's two types of zoom. There's the read zoom, and then there's the write zoom. The write zoom is when you have an area of interest, you're making a box, and you're zooming up that particular area.
Okay.
So you would press the button, and once again, this would allow you trackball to position or size. I recommend you use a combination of the read zoom and the write zoom.
Okay.
You don't want to make it so small that it's going to blow out the pixels or make it unreadable.
Unrecognizable.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. So now that we have that, so you can press that button.
Press the button again. Okay.
So now you've concentrated all your line density in this particular area. But if you still want to zoom up a little bit more, you just turn the button.
Once I'm already in it, I see.
Yes.
And you can move it.
Then
around.
You can pan.
Pan.
Pan. So the baby's moving, you can stay with the baby with
that's
that.
That's nice.
And also, if you freeze the image, then you can still use your read zoom and still zoom
nice.
After the fact
okay.
as well.
That's nice.
And that would be if you had color or anything on there, that there was an area that you really wanted to focus on and take a picture of that, you could do that.
Okay, and then if I unfroze and went to 2D, I'm out of,
correct.
It brings me home.
Yes.
Okay,
mm-hmm.
Nice.
All right, so now let's talk about, we're in 2D now, so these are our 2D controls here that we're able to change certain functions of it to enhance your image. There's a lot of these, there's not a right, wrong answer to, it's a personal preference. The first one is dynamic range. The higher the number, the grayer the image is gonna be.
It's more shades of gray, right? Is that right?
More shades of gray are introduced, yes.
Okay.
The lower the number, the more black and white.
Mm-hmm.
So that's just it's a dynamic range. It's a mm-hmm. compression. A lot of systems will say compression.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so we're here. The next button is the gray map. And once again, that's a personal preference. One, in this case, is more contrasty.
Mm-hmm.
Five is gonna be, or six, a little variation.
Mm-hmm.
All of these will have a little bit different look.
Okay.
Right above that is left, right, invert.
Be careful, don't use it.
Okay.
I say that to most, particularly new users, not to invert your screen. You'll get confused, and if someone does that and another user comes behind you and the screen is flip-flop, you may get confused as to.
Correct.
Yes, so I don't really understand why you may want to use that. Is there a purpose that you can think of?
In OB, not necessarily, but there are some instances where people learned somewhere else and they scan backwards. Why, for the life of me, I don't know.
Yeah, we can't teach it that way.
No, we can't.
So we'll teach it right way.
Yes.
Right. And then I understand some in image guidance, needle guidance, some physicians would prefer to see the needle coming in from a certain direction, so you may have to left, right the screen. That makes sense to me, that's fine. But I think in scanning, we try to suggest that we don't left, right the screen or
right.
invert the upside down.
Yeah, I think it's important they understand it's there because it's on all systems,
mm-hmm.
but I think your comment, don't go there, is good.
Yeah, and this is the indicator, correct?
Correct.
So this is my notch, and this P will tell me that I'm in the correct orientation.
Yes, in reference to where the indicator is on the transducer, yes.
Okay.
Yes. So the next button, a chroma is a color overlay of your 2D image. So if I turn this, you can see that every system's gonna have a different hue.
Mm-hmm.
Some of everybody's eyes see things a little differently. And actually the chroma will help you maybe like help define kidneys a little
mm-hmm.
better, or some subtle structure you'll be able to pick up better. The theory is a human eye sees color better than it does shades of gray.
Mm.
So that's why, and some customers prefer to scan it out all the time. So once again, a personal preference.
It almost takes isoechoic items, like kidneys are not sometimes hard to distinguish, and if you change that color map, it may bring out those subtle differences that you wouldn't normally notice in the gray.
A little better border definition mm-hmm. in some instances.
Okay.
The iron selective electrode. Okay, so it measures sodium, potassium and chloride on this bit of the machine here, and then it puts an aliquot into that dilution turntable at the back. It makes a dilution of that sample with